Yo, what are you saying? I did play. I hear ripping epic. I don't know. I guess I can as I say my queen name. Epic. Epic, baby! Yeah. I'm about to watch another video. I believe it is Izzy versus Annisa. Yeah. Yo, France is staying on their thing with the battles, bro. It was always funny for me. Like, I always said, like, top five battle countries. And battle coins, I mean by battle scenes in general, not individuals. As a collective scene, I always used to say France first, Holland second, third is like UK tied with Germany, because Germany has more heavy hitters, but as a collective scene, the UK has a lot of heavy hitters. But I might be a little bit biased. There's also the fact that the UK was undefeated. The UK hip-hop was undefeated in KOD, so, you know. But anyways, yeah. So, France, Holland, UK, Germany. UK, because obviously, bias. And then Japan. And I put Japan because technically, foundationally, they are solid. If it was a straight foundation battle, Japan would beat anyone. Hands down, untouched. Seeing as I live there now, I can actually see it in person. Bro. Foundations on point, but in terms of the global dancing and how there's other things involved, not just foundation, in terms of musicality, musical storytelling, blow-ups, transitions, I feel Japan is not as innovative as the other scenes, so that's why I would put them as five. Also, just as a general thing, like, they haven't got as many heavy hitters internationally as the other countries do, so yeah. But anyways, let's get into this battle, Izzy versus Annisa. I know Annisa from when I did my review for the Just Debut Barcelona, where France went in. That's so pause. Imagine. Anyways, yeah, but I don't know Izzy, so it should be interesting. I like how they're straight into it. But yeah, let's go. That's just old school hip hop. I say old school, just strong foundations. I'm correcting myself because, meh, cash me. Ooh, that was smooth. Nice. Yeah, she's just taking her time. I don't know who Izzy is, bro, but it's like watching her response, it's as though Izzy is like very crazy, because she's deliberately choosing to stay very grounded, not like try stuff. I don't know. Let's see. Nice. They're responding to that foundation. Ooh, nice plane change. Plane change. Okay. Nice. Nice. I mean, this is a very foundational battle, but I would give it to Annisa right now, because it's like Izzy's, I don't know, Izzy's responding to her foundation, but he's not taking any risks. This is weird. Yeah, it's like they were both trying to respond with a strict foundation. Maybe the song, you know, old school song, so maybe that. She okay? She looks tired. That was nice. That was, watch the footwork. Watch your slide. Ooh, yes, you got blessed by the beat there. The beat blessed you. Unless she knows the song, but I look like the beat blessed her. Okay. Okay. Okay, where's the story going? Ooh. Nice. Okay. I would give that to Annisa. One of them ones. Yeah, one of them ones. Like, yeah, it was a strange battle. Well, not strange. It was like they were very, very rooted in what they were doing. Like in terms of foundation and not experimental, which France is known for. So that was interesting to see. Yeah, but I felt like it was foundation, check, easy. But then Annisa brought more energy in terms of what she was doing with her foundation. She had more variations in terms of what she was doing with her foundation. While Izzy was like, he was experimenting with his stuff, but it was like he was sessioning. Like, well, not like sessioning, like, you know when you go train and you're just, like, moving through your body and just going through the motions and trying to understand where your energy path is flowing. And that's what it was like. It wasn't like he was, like, intentional with what he was doing. So, that, for me, is why I would give it to Annisa in that battle. I guess maybe that's why she won. But, yeah, interesting. Anyways, till the next battle, next time I see you. Peace.